बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम गर्ल्स। एज वी आर डूइंग द रीडिंग ऑफ द चैप्टर एंड आवर चैप्टर नेम इज़ मैस, डेंसिटी एंड टेम्परेचर। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट द मैस, दैट व्हाट इज़ मैस, इट्स साइज यूनिट एंड हाउ वी कैन मेजर द मैस। सो टुडे वी विल मूव टू द डेंसिटी। इन दिस टॉपिक वी विल रीड अबाउट एंड अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द मीनिंग ऑफ अ डेंसिटी एंड इट्स यूनिट्स टू फॉर द मेजरमेंट्स like the SI units and the other units. Next one, how to find out the density of a substance using the density equation, means how we can find out the density having the mass and the volume, that I will explain you further. And the last topic will be about the floating and the sinking of the objects, why some objects float while the others sink. So let's move to the topic. Open the book, all of you, and today our topic, page number is 46. First of all, the density that depends on the mass and the volume. There are two things on which density depends on. First one is a mass and next one is the volume. And the density definition is mass per unit volume, means density of a substance is its mass per unit volume, that we can write down here in this form. Like, this is the equation of a density. To find out the density, we have to know about the mass of a substance and then the volume of a substance. If we divide the mass by its volume, then we can find out its density. This is the formula. Having this formula, we can also find out the SI unit. SI unit of the density is kilogram per meter cube. Here I will explain you how we can find out the SI unit. Density is equal to, we know about the formula of a density, that density is equal to mass by volume, and mass has a SI unit, that is kilogram, and the volume has the SI unit, that is meter cube. So here we have the SI unit of density, that is kilogram per meter cube, and we write down here in this form kilogram per meter cube, and also we can write down here kilogram meter and per cube. This is also kilogram per meter cube. These both are the representation of the SI unit, while the other units to find out the density are gram per centimeter cube, that is the smaller unit of the density, and 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Next one, I will tell you about the density formula, that how we can find out the density, volume and mass by this formula. If we have two things, then the third one thing we can find out. Density formula is density is equal to mass by volume. But if we want to find out the volume of a substance and we have mass and density, then we can replace the density and volume position. Volume will move to the density position and density to the volume. So you can see in this formula that I write down here the volume on the density replacement and density on the volume. So we can find the volume is equal to mass by density. This is the second formula through which we can find out the volume of a substance. And next one, if we want to find out the mass, we have to multiply the volume with the density. So mass is equal to density multiplied by volume. So next one is a mini exercise on the page number 47 that I have explained you earlier, like that is 1 gram per centimeter is equal to how many kilogram per meter cube. 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. So our next one topic is to find out the density of a substance. What steps we use? First one, step one is measure the mass and volume of a substance. Like you can see in this formula that density is equal to mass by volume. So to find out the density, we have to first of all know about the mass and volume of a substance. If we know the mass and volume of a substance, then we can find out the density of a substance. So first step is to measure the mass. First of all, we have to measure the mass and volume of a substance. Second step is divide the mass of a substance by its volume. The result gives the density of a substance. So next one step, we have to divide the mass by its volume. If we divide the mass of a substance by its volume, then we can find out the density of a substance. Our last one topic is about the floating and sinking of the object. The object that have higher mass, they will have higher density, and that's mean if the object have a higher density, they will sink. And next one, the objects that have higher volume, because we know that density depends on mass and the volume. If we had higher mass, that means density is also higher and the objects will sink, while the objects that have higher volume and their density will be low, because they are inversely proportional. If the volume increases, then the density will be decreased, and the objects that have lower density, they will float. So you can see this in the diagram. So this one, you can see in this diagram the floating and sinking of the different objects, like a cork that has a less density, that is only 0.24 gram per centimeter cube, it is floating. And next one, that the corn oil that has a density of 0.9 gram per centimeter cube, that is much larger than the cork, so it is sinking to the cork. Next one, the object that have higher density than the corn oil, that is ice. Ice has a density of 0.9 gram per centimeter cube, that is much lower to the cork. And next one is the water. If we do the comparison between the water and ice, water has a density of 1 gram per centimeter cube, while the ice has a density of 0.92 per gram per centimeter cube. So water is on the lower portion of a substance, of apparatus in a glass or anything, while the ice always float on the water. Next one, if we do the comparison between a glycerine and a glass, glycerine has a density of 1.3 gram per centimeter cube, that is lesser to the glass density. Glass has a density of 2.5 gram per centimeter cube. So the object that has higher density is on the lower portion, 2.5 gram. Next one, glycerine density, that is lesser to the glass, it is above to the glass. And next one, water, that has a less density to the glycerine, it float on the glycerine. And ice has a less density, that float on the water. Corn oil has less density to the ice, so it floats on the ice. And cork has a much less density, that is only 0.24 gram per centimeter cube, so it is all above on these things. So this was the concept actually about the floating and sinking of the object. So this was our today's topic, and you have to do the reading from the page number 46 to 49. Do the reading of this chapter. Allah Hafiz.